Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about how God actually sets somebody free from a porn and masturbation addiction or sexual perversion addiction. Because it's one thing to hear somebody talk about how God set them free from something, but then it's another thing to actually know how He did it. So I just want to just talk to you briefly about how God can set somebody free from a porn addiction. It doesn't have to happen the same way every time, but like Jesus said, it's the truth that sets you free. So I just want to just give you just a brief overview of a typical scenario of how God sets somebody free from a porn, masturbation, or sexual perversion addiction. And just remember that when you're surfing porn, God is surfing you, so to speak. So everything you're doing is being recorded and can be used as evidence against you if you don't repent of this addiction. But how it usually happens is, first of all, it happens from conviction. In other words, if you've got a porn, masturbation, or sexual perversion addiction, you have to realize that what you're doing is wrong, not just in your head, but in your heart. And what God will do is He will come to you and He will communicate to you in some way that what you're doing is not only really harmful for you, but it's dangerous. It's spiritually dangerous. And because He knows the end result of what's going to happen to somebody, so He wants to warn you. And what had happened for me is that I just, one night, I was crying out to God for help because I was just trapped in a porn addiction. And I began to see a vision, and what I saw is I saw a bunch of people marching through a valley in what looked like hell. And it was just vast. And in the crowd, I could see people that looked like they must have been porn actresses or actors or whatever. You could just kind of tell. And we were all, there were so many people, they were all marching towards something, and I could feel in my spirit, I was in that crowd, that they were marching towards their judgment, toward hell, whatever it was. And it was a horrible, horrible feeling. It was a very dark place. And but up, way up on a cliff, I could see a figure dressed in white. I knew it was Jesus. And as the crowd was pushing, because the crowd pushes you on, as they were pushing me on, I kept trying to yell at the Lord, but the noise was just so great. I guess He just couldn't hear me. But just as we were passing Him, my eyes were still fixed on Him. He looked straight at me without speaking. He just said, "Unless you repent in earnest, you will receive the same fate as these others who do such things." And that was the end of it. And it so alarmed me that I just jumped up and I got online and tried to find anything I could to get some help. And I found a place called Setting Captives Free. They have a course called The Way of Purity. I enrolled right away. But most of what happened for me to set me free was the Holy Spirit began to set me free. And like I said earlier, it's the truth that sets us free. And but I just realized after that point that as a Christian, there is no free getting free card to heaven. That if you're going to live a sinful life, and just like Jesus said in Matthew 24, that if He has a servant that is constantly sinning because he knows his master's away, he's going to receive a place with the unbelievers when that master returns. And I realized that I couldn't just do whatever I wanted, and that just saying you're sorry all the time isn't enough. You have to repent, meaning you've got to stop doing it. You can't just keep saying you're sorry. And so I got serious, and I asked the Lord to help me. And even though I couldn't set myself free, I got serious about letting Him set me free. And so conviction is the first part. And God will just make it very clear to you in whatever way is necessary, if you're willing to pray to Him, that what you're doing is absolutely lethal. Jesus said, "Whoever looks on a woman to lust after her in his heart has committed adultery already." So every time you're masturbating and imagining having sex with somebody, or you're viewing porn, you're committing adultery in your heart, and it's going to count just like real adultery. And you can either believe it now or believe it later, but Jesus doesn't lie, He doesn't exaggerate. So you can either believe what He said now, or you can believe it when you're standing in front of Him. It's better to believe it now while you still have a chance to change things. Just like Ebenezer Scrooge, you still have a chance to change your fate. And God's giving you a chance today by watching this video. Number two, it's revelation. God began to reveal things to me, to show me, to change. In other words, I had like porn-colored glasses on where I would view things a certain way, just as pleasure abuse, you know. Wherever the next fix is, you go surfing. But what the Lord did is He began to erase what was written on my glasses, my lie glasses, if you want to call it that. And He began to write truth on there. And some of the truths that the Lord showed me was, number one, that He created the bodies that I was looking at. And those were designed by him. So when you abuse his creation, you're abusing him, and he's going to take it very personally. And so what you're viewing is not just a pleasure fix. It's something that was magnificently designed by the Creator to be used in a proper fashion. It was never meant to be abused and used that way, even though the person's doing it. And so when you abuse his creation, you abuse him. But also, all the porn that you're viewing is going to be used as evidence against that person that's doing that. What you're viewing is spiritual evidence that when that person has to go before the Lord, they're going to have to see that porn movie or those porn pictures or whatever it is. And it's going to be used as evidence against you too. There's a, just like there's, you know, a picture taken of what they're doing, you're being filmed as well. Like I said earlier, just like you're surfing porn, God's surfing you. And there's a camera in heaven on you 24 hours a day. And this, unless you repent, I mean, really stop doing something and let God help you, that will be used as evidence against you. So just understand you're viewing evidence, and you're also helping every click you click to view another porn picture is helping somebody else go to hell, because they count the number of hits on a site, and that's how they determine whether it's effective or not. So you're helping somebody to go to hell. They're just going to make more porn with all the money or the hits they get on a site. So you're helping somebody go to hell when you're viewing porn. And it's just, once you begin to view things that way, you'll no longer, God will kind of take the fun out of it for you. In other words, when you see something like that, what you're going to see is the naked body of somebody that's being disobedient with their body and who's going to face a horrible judgment. And you're actually going to feel sorry for them. You're not going to feel lustful toward them or anything else. And you're just going to feel very sorry for them. And there won't be so much of a fix in it anymore for you. And you're just going to want to walk in truth. In other words, like I said, you're going to have truth glasses on after that, where everything you view will be viewed through truth, including, you know, viewing people in public, all of those other things. You'll be able to see things from now on with truth glasses instead of lust glasses or porn glasses or whatever you want to call it. But it is the truth. It's a revelation of the truth given by God that sets you free. And like I said, the action needs to be repentance. As a Christian or as a person, you can't just keep saying you're sorry to God like some credit card with an endless limit and thinking that you're just going to be forgiven forever. You need to repent. Like Jesus said in Revelation 3, repent in earnest or he's going to come and you're going to face a judgment for it. And that means you can't just keep saying you're sorry every time you do something wrong. You've got to stop doing it. You've got to ask God to help you. If you can't stop sinning, then ask God to help you. And you know, nobody's forced to view porn. Nobody has a gun to your head. You'll notice when you're in public, you don't view porn at the grocery store or you know, take your clothes off or masturbate in the middle of the street. You have the ability to say no, and you have to understand that. You can say no. And God's going to expect that of you when you face him. He's going to say no. You could have said no. You just didn't want to. You chose pleasure over obedience. And from now on, you've got to refuse the illegal pleasure, and you've got to choose obedience, because there's a terrible judgment coming on the earth very soon. And Jesus Christ is returning very soon to set up his kingdom here on earth. And only those who have lived a consistently obedient life to his kingdom laws will be led into that kingdom. Everybody else will be sent to hell. And this isn't just scare talk, it's Bible talk. It's Jesus talk, and that's what he said, and we need to take it seriously. And because judgment is coming. And porn is so easy to view because anybody can view it in their home, but it's so dangerous. That's the problem, is that what you think you're doing in secret is not secret at all in heaven. Anybody can see what you're doing. And better to clean it up now than to wait till you're standing before the Lord and you have no way to change it. So change that life movie that you're going to see about your life. Do you want to see yourself in heaven on a big screen viewing porn and sinning? Or do you want to see a picture of you, a movie of you repenting and living obediently to God and getting into heaven? Well, you have a chance to edit your life movie right now. And there's a free e-course at Setting Captives Free, like I said, called The Way of Purity. Or you can go to any of my websites, just go to my YouTube homepage and go to the main hub for that. You can find it there. But just pray, ask the Holy Spirit, get baptized in the Holy Spirit. He's the counselor. He'll help you to get free from the inside out. And take this very seriously. This is nothing to play around with. It doesn't matter how many people around you abuse and sin. You need to repent. So bless you, my friend. I hope this has helped you a little bit. Okay? Bye-bye.